How's she doing?
Just don't you discourage her. She keeps up this practice and she'll be able to play real good.
I'll be back in an hour.
Okay, I'll take good care of her. All right, hop to it, Mary. Mary, give me an A.
Serious?
It is to me. I want to keep the name of Haskell in the health food business.
Yeah, well, I understand how you feel, Uncle Charlie. I want to keep the name of Haskell in the music business.
I'm talking about big business. Can't you understand? I need you, Jimmy. And someday you're going to get everything I've got. But you're not going to get it if you persist in frittering your life away in this town. this whistle stop.
I like it here. My dad was happy here.
Oh, I could never understand my brother. And I told him when he opened this place he'd never make a go of it.
Well, he kept it failing successfully for 25 years. That's not bad.
If he'd listened to me, he'd been a rich man. But no. So what did he have when he died?
The biggest funeral this town ever saw. Everybody was there.
Why not? Everybody owed him money.
Maybe so. Dad just had a wonderful time living. He liked things. He liked to hunt and fish. He liked music.
Music!
He talked a great deal about you.
He did?
Always seemed to feel so sorry for you.
Sorry for me?
Didn't get anything out of life. Just making money.
Is that so? Since when has making money been a crime? Since when? Oh, I'm not going to argue with you. And I'm not going to let myself be upset. No, sir. Get it! Get it!
Uncle, I'm sorry.
Don't hit him, Jimmy. He's an old man.
No, it was just a chair, you see. Are you hurt, Uncle Charlie?
Oh, don't mind me.
Oh, hello, bud. Can I talk to you for a minute? Oh, yeah, well, outside here. Will you excuse me a minute, Uncle Charlie? Afraid I got some bad news for you, Jimmy.
Oh, what's the trouble, bud? I'm supposed to pack up this attachment unless you can dig up some money.
Oh. Well, I guess you have to pack it up. Unless you think eggs are going to go up to $500 a dozen all of a sudden.
Well, see what you can do. I'll hold this off as long as I can.
Okay, thanks, bud. You're just telling me about some people that wanted some musical instruments.
He's the sheriff, isn't he?
How'd you know?
I knew his father. He was serving a paper on your father the first time I came up here.
That's right.
Well, Jimmy, what's it going to be? You can stay here chasing rainbows, or you can come with me. I can show you a real pot of gold that's yours for the taking. Wait a minute. That's a good idea for my radio program tomorrow night. You've heard my happiness hour, of course.
Oh, yes, everybody's heard that. Once.
Listen to this. The clouds that make the day so gray must sooner or later pass away. There's always a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. Good old homespun philosophy.
Oh, boy.
Well, I've got to be going. What are you going to do?
Well, I'll tell you, Uncle Charlie. Unless a miracle happens in the next few days, looks like I'll slide down that rainbow.
Fine.
Land right in the pot.
What was I saying?
And furthermore,
I see no reason for changing. And furthermore, I see no reason for changing the air guns we are now using to puff our rice and other cereals. Our present air guns are exceptionally quiet in operation. I therefore would suggest that. There goes that band again. How can a man transact any business with that going on day after day? Tom-toms, jungle screeches. They're a menace to sanity. What did I say?
Tom-toms and jungle screeches.
No, but that's what I mean. The McCorkles took that band in their house just to annoy me. That's why they've ignored all of my protests.
Well, I understand it's a new band just organized.
Who wants a new band? Let them organize in the cave somewhere. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 boom. I'll settle this once and for all.
What's the matter?
Stop that blasted bedlam, or I'll have it stopped.
Oh, you will, eh? You and who else?
The police. I'll have that gang of noisy loafers thrown in jail for disturbing the peace.
Disturbing the peace, are we? What about that air gun of yours booming all day and night? I suppose that's a baby's lullaby, you white-headed old baboon.
That booming is business, and besides, we're all used to it.
The band is business, and you'll get used to a tour at your own hard luck.
I'll get out an injunction.
Oh, you will, eh? Well, listen, you black-hearted old skinflint. For years, you've tried every trick to make me sell my house here so you could enlarge your factory. Well, I'm not selling Haskell, not at your price. So go ahead. Call the cops if you think you can have this band thrown out of here.
You just wait. You'll find out.
Go ahead, boys. Go to it, but loud.
Jasper. Go get Jasper. 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 Go get him. Find him. Don't stand there like a dummy. Do I have to do everything myself around here? Jasper. Jasper!
You want me, CJ?
Do I want you? Why aren't you here when I need you? Go get the police!
The police, CJ?
The militia, if necessary. That McCorkle woman has insulted me for the last time.
But you said that before, CJ.
I know, but this time I mean it. That band is driving me insane.
Certainly is.
Well, have him arrested.
I will.
Good!
Hi, Si. What's cooking? Hi, Si. How's she looking? Life will be as sweet as can be if I can find a cookie that's a-looking for me.
Hi, Si. I'm turning on this time, turning like a tiger.
All day long, I wash and dry to be my little cookie all the way from Shanghai.
Shine for you. 10 cents to fly the revenue. Your dog will get a real shampoo. The real magoo. Ha!
Ha! Rush this!
Bum-dee-dum-doo, diddly-dum. The fortune teller told me I was going to clean up.
Are the apples good?
Just like I sell the Ritz-Carlton.
But well, then they ought to do for the McCorkle. I'll take a half a dozen. Here, Willie.
What am I, a pack horse?
Will be anything else, Miss Molly?
No, that'll be all, thank you. Here, stupid. Well, take it. Thank you. Come on. Too bad you can't carry a few bundles without complaining.
Oh, I don't mind carrying them.
Well, who are you?
I'm the guy carrying the bundles.
Well, thanks. I thought my brother Willie was behind me.
Oh, no, he went ahead of you.
I'm terribly sorry. You must have been surprised.
No, I guess life in the big city just one big surprise after the other.
For instance?
Well, for instance, band music coming down out of the sky in broad daylight.
Oh, that's up on our roof.
On your roof, is it?
The band is strictly on the house until we get a job.
Well, you with the band?
Well, my sister Donna and I sing with it. My brother plays in it, but Mother feeds it.
Oh, well, it certainly is a swell band.
There's a slight difference of opinion around here about that.
Oh, you mean the neighbors object?
Oh, no, the neighbors are... Uh-oh, here comes trouble.
Well, Mr. Coggle, as you can see, I'm here with the law.
For protection, huh?
Certainly not. We are here to give you the last warning. That music must cease, definitely, once and for all.
I'm coming, Molly. What does this weasel want this time as if I didn't know?
No violence now. Speak to her, officer.
Hello, Mom.
You're in bad company, Mac.
Well, I've been sent to deliver an ultimatum.
Oh, you have you?
Yes, and that band must go. They're disturbing the peace of the entire neighborhood.
Well, the entire neighborhood. Does it disturb you, Mrs. Papadopoulos?
Not to me. It keeps me young.
Disturbing the peace. What about you, Mrs. Sweeney?
It's a big advantage to me. My old man can't fight when he hears music.
They will, Willie. The ruffians.
Now, go back to your kennel and tell old man Haskell what you've had. Why now?
Hey, what's going on here?
You've heard about the feud between the Hatfields and the McCoys, haven't you?
Yeah.
Well, this is the one between the McCorkles and the Haskells.
What'd you say? Who?
Come on.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm looking for a nice song.
Oh, quit kicking me!
Look out.
Now, just a minute. You might miss him.
Now, you hoodlum! You'll pay for this, you hoodlum!
Now!
Let us I can.
Gosh, you hit the wrong man.
Oh, no, you didn't. You hit the right man. Run!
Well, wait.
Come on!
Oh, they got me. Oh, it's blood! I've been shot. I've been stabbed.
You're all right, CJ. Take it easy.
No, I'm not all right. Call a doctor. Call an ambulance.
But that isn't blood, CJ.
It isn't blood? Well, what is it? What is it?
Tomato juice. Somebody has given me tomato.
Oh, clear. Come on in.
Boy, you sure do know your backyards and fences.
Oh, I'd have made better time yet if I hadn't had to wait for you.
Well, I didn't want to ask you to carry my suitcase.
Have a donut, Hero. The best I can offer.
Hero, me?
You certainly are. You know, I wouldn't be surprised if they put up a statue of you throwing that tomato. You know, like the discus fella.
Oh, well, that was an accident, hitting my, that man.
Accident? That was a stroke of genius. If you only knew how everybody hates old man Haskell.
I do what?
Why? I could give you a reason for every dollar he's got in the bank. Do you know that he's trying to drive us out of our home because he doesn't like music?
That's sort of a stinker, isn't it?
And how? Believe me, the name of Haskell's pure poison around here.
Guess I'd better be going.
Oh, what's your hurry?
Well, I have to find a place to live. I sort of expected to live with a relative of mine, but it doesn't seem like a very good idea now.
Well, if you'd like a place where there's never a dull moment, what's the matter with this?
Well, I didn't know.
What's going on here? Who are you and what do you want?
Mommy's looking for a place to live.
Oh, are you a new member of the band or would you be living here at a cash basis?
Mom, this is the fellow that hit old man Haskell with a tomato.
Oh, glory be. Oh, you darling, why didn't you tell me? So you're the fellow. Now, listen, young man. You're not looking any further. You're going to live right here with us. Here, give me the bag.
Well, that's very nice of you, but...
But me no buts now. Why, the best room in the house is none too good for you. Whether you can pay for it or not. Come on now, give me the bag.
Well,
you're not leaving this
house.
I'll take
the bag.
Willie, where are you?
Hey, Molly, been looking for you. Had that arrangement finished.
Say when he starts to play, the kids begin to trail him, and they all say, hooray for Pete the Piper. When he plays a song, all the kids will never fail him. They sing a song along with Pete the Piper. People gather round when they hear the sound. The camels are coming, hooray, hooray, when their lively feet catch the piper's beat. They start to sway, and then it isn't long till all the folks are dancing, their hearts are gay, when he will play them a song. When he's done all that, they pass the hat for fascinating Pete the Piper Man.
Sorry, I didn't mean to butt in. Get them, boys. Say, I didn't mean to bust things
Quiet,
up.
Quiet, please. Can you read music?
Sure.
Play it like this.
Me?
Stand over there. Okay, Frankie, pick it up.
Thank you.
people gather round when they hear the song.
The camels are coming.
Hooray! Hooray!
Now it won't be long till all the folks are dancing. Their hearts are gay when he will play them a song. When he's done all that, they pass the hat for pass the date to beat the piper band.
Fascinating, beat the Piper Man.
Boys, look who's here, Grady.
Grady's been pounding a beat out by the garbage dumps. A little argument with old man Haskell.
Oh, Grady, you should have been here a little while ago. You'd have been even for life.
Yeah, what happened?
Oh, boy, plenty.
What they call poetic justice.
It must have been good.
God, it was perfect.
Well, come on, out with it.
Well, old man Haskell came steaming over here.
Yeah?
And he got hit with a tomato.
Oh! Right in the kitchen. It was a soft one, naturally.
The hit and run kind.
Nobody knows who did it, I hope.
No, nobody but me. But I'm big-hearted. Boys, meet the sharpshooter.
Molly McCorkle, will you never learn to keep your big mouth shut?
What did I say?
Too much.
Open up, boys. Open up. The break. Open up.
My boy, you should have a medal. Yes, sir. I'm sorry I can't be giving you one instead of this.
Oh, thanks very much. What is it?
It's a warrant for assault and battery. Old man Haskell swore it out.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, son.
Wait a minute. Grady. Wouldn't you like to give me a good swift kick before you go?
Oh, that's all right. This has been fun here, and I enjoyed jumping over those fences with you. If I ever get this thing straightened out, I hope you'll let me come back sometime. And, thanks for that donut. That was all right. Well, come on, Grady.
Yeah.
The next case.
Hold everything, Judge. We'll be right there. Molly, where are you? Come on, hook me up the case and start it.
Order. Order in the courtroom. Mary McCorkle, sit down.
Now listen, Mike. Don't you be getting on your high horse with me.
Sit down. Now, what's this case all about? Young man, what's your name?
My name?
I'd prefer your real name.
My name is James Hamilton.
James Hamilton? Now, put that down. And where do you live, James Hamilton?
He lives with us at my house.
419 63rd Street. Now, tell me, James, how did you get enmeshed in the coils of the law?
I threw a tomato.
He's still modest, Mike. Came in a bullseye right in old man Haskell's face.
He did? Where were we?
I'd just thrown the tomato, Your Honor.
Yes. Now tell me, Jimmy, my boy, did you, with premeditation and intent, deliberately aim at the aforesaid Haskell's face?
Well...
The defendant refuses to answer on the grounds that he might incriminate himself.
Glory be, Mike, you certainly know the law.
Having weighed the evidence, the court rules that the case be postponed and the defendant released on bail. Provided anybody has any money.
We have $200. Is that enough?
That was the exact sum that the court had in mind. Who has it?
I have it, Your Honor.
The clerk will accept it. Next case.
Thank you, Mike.
Stand aside, please. Will you move over?
Oh, hold your portion.
I'm not pushing you.
Take it easy.
Don't you push me.
Here comes double pneumonia.
Open the windows, boys. I smell stale tomatoes.
Very funny, Mrs. McCorkle. Very funny. I only wish it had been you that threw that tomato.
So do I. Only I'd have put a rock in it.
No, you wouldn't. Well, let me tell you. Proceed with the case, Judge. I'm here. Where's the man that assaulted me?
If you don't mind, I'll conduct this case without any advice from you.
Let's get him, Mike.
Move along. In you go. All right, take it away, Eddie.
I bring a legitimate charge against the hoodlum. And before I can give my evidence, the thug is permitted to walk out right under your nose.
In the first place, he wasn't under my nose. And in the second place, the defendant was released on bail. And in the third place, you're in contempt of court. And I sentence you to 25 days or $25.
Oh, that ain't enough, Mike.
Quiet, quiet.
This is an outrage. It's a travesty on justice.
$50 or 50 days.
What?
Make up your mind.
It's worth 50 to tell you what I think.
Is it worth 100?
All right. But you wait until the next election. You wait until...
I'm waiting.
Until the... Your Honor, it appears that I haven't any money with me.
Take him away, bailiff.
You can't do this to me!
Court declares recess.
You can't do this to me!
The bugle knows the call from A to Z, but he's always at his best when blowing reveille. When Johnny toots his horn, disturbing the peace at break of the dawn,
you gotta get up.
You're in the army now. Before your eyes are open, you're dressing on the run and standing at attention with the sergeant's hat and the corporal's gun.
Oh, Johnny blows and blows.
He totally toots you into your clothes and makes you rue the day that you were born.
Day you were born.
There's nothing anyone can do.
The captain has to make it too. You gotta get up when Johnny toots his horn.
He toots you out of slumber, he toots you out of bed, he toots you into line and then he goes somewhere and he hangs his head.
But still he blows and blows and blows, blows and blows, blows and blows, blows and blows, blows and blows and blows, yeah, yeah.
He wakes you with this crazy tune that goes to bed and sleeps till noon.
You gotta get up when Johnny toots his horn.
He stands stands behind the barricade and plays his morning serenade.
The private gets up.
The corporal gets up.
The sergeant gets up.
The lieutenant gets up.
The captain gets up.
The major gets up.
The colonel gets up.
The general gets up.
The army gets up.
The brigadier gets up.
The army toots his horn.
Music! Music! Even in jail, I hear music.
You'll get used to it.
Let me down! Take your hands off of me and stop this nonsense! You're nothing but a lot of hoodlums! Jimmy, my boy.
Uncle Charlie, well, fancy meeting you here.
It's a gross miscarriage of justice. But they can't do this to me. On the other hand, what are you doing here?
Oh, well, just another country boy got mixed up with a lot of evil companions.
What's wrong, Sheriff? We have more prisoners in here than we have commitments.
Someone sneaked into our jail.
What?
Yeah. Defrauding the taxpayers, that's what it is. All right, gangway boys, come on, come on. Line up over there, line up. You, what's your name?
Haskell.
Haskell.
Okay, we got a Haskell.
All right, stand over there. What's your name?
Haskell.
You, oh, wise guy, huh? I suppose you're all named Haskell.
Yeah!
What's your initials?
James H.
I got no James H. nothing.
So you're the stowaway. Come on, get out of here. You ought to be locked up for pulling a stunt like this.
James, my wallet is on my desk in the office. Get it and pay my fine, will you?
Okay, I'll be right back. So long, fellas.
So long, Jimmy. So long, Jimmy. So long.
Hey, can you sing?
No, I hate music.
We gotta do something about this, boys.
Yeah.
Hey, Jimmy, where have you been?
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, me? Oh, what's the matter?
Well, we've been looking all over town for you.
Yeah.
Yeah? What for? What bar? Oh, boy.
Come on.
Hey, here's Jim. Molly. Jimmy's here.
What? What did I tell you? I knew he'd come back. What happened and where have you been?
Well, I got locked up again by mistake.
Oh, you certainly had the boys worried. They've been sitting here chewing their fingernails, thinking you'd run out on them.
Well, why am I so popular all of a sudden?
Well, they pawned their instruments to bail you out.
Molly's idea.
Oh, thanks. Very nice to know that I'm worth $200 on the hoof.
First call for dinner! Oh. Jimmy, you're back. Oh, you'll be at the first table. Take care of him, Molly. Don't touch a thing. Get up from the table, all of you.
Why, what's the matter, Ma?
Have you forgotten you have a new member she initiated to the clan?
Here, you sit next to her. What?
Come on,
Willie, get up.
Come on now and stop your grumbling.
Hail McCorkle,
hail McCorkle, we'll proudly sing thy praise. Hail McCorkle, hail McCorkle,
where no one ever pays.
This university by the fraternity, so full of knowledge, rah, rah, welcome to our little college. Hooray! And as we march along, we'll sing our college song. A knife, a fork, and a spoon will be down the happy doom. You'll all feel chummy as you fill your tummy with a knife, a fork, and a spoon. Start tap, tap, tap in a dish. You'll get your favorite wish. Nights and troubles dashing while you're gone, be patching with a knife, a fork and a spoon. At Mama Corkle's table, that's where we play each night. We eat all that we're able, so we may fuss, it's home to us. So come on, lift up your cup. Let's drink it down, bottoms up. Through stormy weather, we'll all stick together with a knife, a fork and a spoon.
Consider yourself a full-fledged member of the McCorkle clan.
Oh, well, do I make a speech?
If you do, you'll starve to death.
Hey, look at this Irish stew. There
you are. Tomatoes?
Thank you.
Well, help yourself.
No tomatoes.
Would you excuse me? I don't feel very well.
Oh, it's probably too much excitement.
Oh, maybe you're right. The jail and everything. Well, I think I'll be all right if I go out and get some fresh air.
Willie, you'd better go with him.
Sure.
Oh, well, you don't. Well, maybe I'd be better off if I just went up to my room for a while.
Willie, show him his room.
Come on. Willie does everything around here except eat.
If you want anything, just holler.
Home sweet home.
Oh, thanks. Papa.
Johnny toots his horn, disturbing a feast of regular on, you gotta get up.
No, no, no.
That's outrageous, outrageous.
I know it, but you're getting better.
I don't want to be better, and I still hate music.
You're so unreasonable.
All right, all right, all right, all right.
Now try it again and put in some gestures.
When Johnny toots his horn, disturbing a feast of regular on, you gotta get up. You're in the army now, before your eyes are open, you're resting on the run.
The corporal's got the sergeant at detention with his gun.
And now he blows and blows, he totally dooks you with your calls and makes you
move. Alive! Alive! Alive!
Where have you been? You'll be sorry for this. Look what they've done to my voice. How am I going to broadcast the Haskell Happiness Hour tonight?
Well, would there be any complaints if you just called the whole thing off?
What?
Yeah, tell them you lost your voice singing in a jail.
Don't be ridiculous!
Ladies and gentlemen, due to circumstances beyond our control...
We again bring you the Haskell Hour of Happiness with C.J. Haskell, makers of Haskell Paddock Cakes, the health food supreme.
Ladies and gentlemen! I can't do it. I'm sick. I'm croaking. Jimmy, you do it for me.
Oh, yes.
None of that.
No.
Mr. Haskell will be with you in just a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen!
Tonight, I want to share a little poem with you. We all should be grateful and happy as kings. The world is so full of such wonderful things. The rain and the sun help the earth to grow wheat. Perhaps it's the most
wonderful
of any cereal we eat.
What do you want? Listen to this, will you?
The sun on the ocean sparkling and bright.
What do you want to listen to that stuff for?
Just
listen
for a moment. The trees and the planets at night. The pansies and lilies, the primrose so fickle, they're ours to enjoy without spending a nickel. The brain.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, Box.
Box?
Is the guest room in order?
Certainly, sir.
This is my nephew, Mr. James Haskell.
Oh. How do you do, sir?
Same to you.
Partly.
Is your luggage in the car, sir?
Luggage? Oh, I just had one suitcase and I left...
What are you whispering about?
I don't know. You started it, sir.
I lost my voice singing.
Singing? You, sir?
Yes, I was...
I think I'd better go and get my suitcase.
You won't need it. We have everything here. Come on. Well, here you are, my boy. This is all yours from now on. I'm so happy to have you with me at last.
Oh, thank you, sir.
In case you need anything, it's right there.
Oh, that's fine.
We'll have breakfast at 7:30, then I'll take you over to the factory and introduce you around. Best of all, I'm going to put you on the payroll. I don't imagine you've got much money.
Well, your cashier cashed a check for me.
Your personal check? How much?
Oh, no, it was certified. $214, that's what was left when I closed up shop.
Oh, well, that dismal episode is behind you forever, my boy. Tomorrow is another day. With more music by the McCorkles, probably. Jimmy! That old lady is deliberately trying to wreck my health.
But why?
Just because I want her property.
Oh, that's very unreasonable.
It's getting on my nerves. I can't stand it any longer.
Well, Uncle Charlie, why don't you go on a vacation?
And let the McCorkles think that they're chasing me out of town? That's just what they want. Nothing is going to stand in the way of my getting the man who hit me with that tomato. This is my room if you want me. I'm going to take a hot bath and a hot toddy and go to bed. Good night, Jim.
Goodbye, Charlie.
Upon the sea,
la, 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 la.
Who
me be my queen.
In this beautiful land of laughter, you'll live happily ever after.
If you believe the fairy tales come true.
Heard you on the radio.
You did. Wasn't I terrible? Yeah. Molly hear it?
No.
No, she didn't. Well, that's good.
Look, just what goes on between you and C.J. Haskell?
Oh. Well, I might as well tell you. He's my uncle.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, well, here, I'll prove it to you. Here's a letter he sent me. To James Hamilton Haskell. That's me. Here. You want to read it?
No, I read enough.
Say, what is this? What are you doing here?
Oh. Well, I almost forgot what it came for. In the first place, there's $200. Now you can get your instruments out of Hawk.
Did you get that from your uncle?
You don't know my uncle.
Thanks, Jim.
That's all right. That's all right. I like the people in this house. Especially, well, I like everybody. I sort of like to live here all the time. But as soon as Molly finds out who I am, she'll kick me out in the alley.
Well, suppose she doesn't find out.
Well, that'd be very nice, but...
Now, look, you've been regular. You didn't have to come across with that dough. I'm for you, Jimmy.
How about you, Hart? Sure thing. I'm for you.
Well, thanks very much. That's... No, I still got troubles. Don't you see, sooner or later, Molly's going to find out who I am. Just like sooner or later, old man Haskell's going to find out who threw that tomato. And then it just won't work. Either way, I'm a dead duck.
But how's your uncle going to find out?
Well, he'll see me at the trial, won't he?
What would happen if Uncle Charlie didn't show up for the trial?
They'd throw the case out of court.
But there's your answer.
We get rid of Uncle Charlie.
How?
Well, we let Red run over him with the ice wagon.
What do you think he'd do it? Oh, you couldn't do that.
What do you mean we couldn't do that? Red would love it. I'll go get him.
Oh, wait a minute. Hold on here. Couldn't you do something not quite so drastic? Any ideas?
Yeah, I think I'd better go back to Point Jervis. Uncle Charlie's a pretty tough guy to deal with. And from the way he talked tonight, you better find someplace else to rehearse your band. Well, so long, Horace.
Well, so long, Jim.
Sorry about this. Willie, thanks for everything.
So long, Jimmy.
Jim, wait a minute.
What?
That's it. The band. He doesn't like it.
No, he certainly does not. What?
Come on.
Come on.
Uncle Charlie?
Jimmy, what are you doing down here? Who is this man?
Well, I'll tell you, Uncle Charlie, I got worried about you. I couldn't sleep, so I called in a specialist. Now, this is Professor Height. This is my Uncle Charlie.
Oh, nonsense. I don't need a doctor. I eat my own health foods. It's my nerves that are cracking.
That's why I'm here, Mr. Haskell, to work on your nerves. Relax, please.
Relax? How can anybody relax with that music going on?
Music? What music?
That creepy music. Do you hear it?
You see what I mean, Professor?
I tell you, I hear music. Maybe it's the radio in the library. It's not the radio.
Do you still hear it, Uncle Charlie?
Yes, it's still playing.
Mr. Haskell, tell me, where does this music seem to be coming from?
I don't know, but just a moment. I'll tell you. It's here. It's plainer down here.
Uncle Charlie, don't you think you better go back to bed?
I tell you, Jimmy, I hear it. Here. Yeah, here it is. It's coming from the furnace.
Music in furnace.
Well, listen yourself. Jimmy, please tell me. You hear it? I'll get Parks. He'll get me out of this. Parks will back me up. You see if he don't.
What's the matter?
You don't hear anything.
Oh, yes.
It's about time. I was beginning to get nervous.
Beautiful string quartet.
String quartet. It's bugles.
Here's bugles on phone.
I tell you, I hear bugles.
It's bugles.
Don't try to humor me.
Oh, all right. Now, let's go and get some air. You've nothing to worry about until you start seeing things.
There's nothing wrong with me.
What do you want us to see, Uncle?
Girls dancing on the lawn.
Where?
There.
paper dolls dancing on lawns.
Paper dolls! You're right, Jimmy. I am in terrible shape. My nerves are all gone. Doctor, what do you think I'd better do?
Mr. Haskell, give your nerves a good long rest. Get out of town.
I'll do it. I'll go up in the woods.
Fine, we'll help you pack.
No, not until I find the man who threw that tomato.
Now, Uncle Charlie, your health is much more important than that silly tomato.
Yes, Mr. Haskell, that's right.
Sure, now let me handle this. I'll put the finger on that fellow. He's as good as in jail right now. Almost. And while you're up there resting, he'll be well taken care of. Don't worry about that. And I'm the guy that can do it.
Good. I take the first train out in the morning. Oh,
what's the matter now?
The music stopped. All but the bull fiddle.
You see, you're improving already.
Yeah. Hi, Mr. Haskell. What can I do for you?
Hello, Miss Lauderman. Well, I just dropped in to see if we couldn't make the Haskell Happiness Hour a little bit happier.
Welcome, stranger. Sit right down. What do you have to drink?
Well,
Hello, Mr. Backus.
What's the purpose of this meeting?
Well, we were about to discuss the program.
You know very well that I have charge of the Happiness Hour during Mr. Haskell's absence. He trusts me implicitly.
Well, not 100%.
I beg your pardon.
Look, I have a note from my uncle giving me complete charge of the program. Hmm?
Well, it didn't take you long to undermine me with your uncle, did it?
Mm-mm.
How do I know you didn't write that yourself? Now, listen, Mr. Lauderman, there'll be no change...
Would you excuse us a minute? I'd like to talk to you.
Yes, we had better talk to you.
Yeah, yeah. Be right back.
Oh!
Like to make some other improvements, too.
Go right ahead.
Well, I'd like to use a band.
No, please, no. We're overloaded with bands.
No, but this is ideal, because my uncle hates it.
What?
Yeah, it drove him clear up to Canada.
Well, then what do you want to put down his program for?
Well, it's pretty hard to explain, but you see, it'll give the band a break, and then they'll have to thank my uncle for it, and that'll make him feel pretty good.
Up in Canada?
Up in Canada. Yeah, and there's sort of a feud going on.
A feud?
Uh-huh. And then there's a girl.
Oh, a girl.
Yeah. Hmm. Sounds pretty confusing, doesn't it?
Well, no, it sounds pretty good.
Is that? Well, that's it. You play Thursday night over a coast-to-coast hookup at the opening of the East Chester Country Club.
That's great, Jim. How did you ever do it?
Well, I don't know. I just started to talk. The fellow listened. I'm just as surprised about it as you are.
How much did we get for it?
Nothing.
Nothing?
No, you don't get anything.
Oh.
Well, what of it? Is it any different than playing for the neighbors and old man Haskell? What do we get out of that? At least this way there's a chance.
I'm Saul. What can we lose? That's all right for me.
Hey, give me a push.
Bonsoir, monsieur.
What did he say?
Bonsoir, monsieur.
What? And you made me drag this pack through the woods for 4 hours to get to a place where nobody can talk English. What kind of a guide are you, anyway? Hey, Pierre. Avez-vous machine talkie-talkie?
No, I don't think so. I've got a good one right there.
I'm not a peddler. This one is busted. I want to hear a program in America that goes on at 8 o'clock.
Well, help yourself.
Here, get this avalanche off my back.
Oui, monsieur.
Oui, monsieur.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That's all right now. We're about to start our broadcast.
Well, boys, here we go. Good luck.
What, are you scared? Oh, just take a deep breath.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The Haskell Happiness Hour comes to you tonight from the dining patio of the exclusive East Chester Country Club.
Country Club? What the...
This marks the first appearance on the air of a new band.
Horace music! Ike,
and his
on
musical
my
life.
Program?
Thank you and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Horace Height, and the first number on our program is Broadway Caballero.
featuring Miss Molly McCorkle.
McCorkle!
And here she is, the charming Molly.
He's disarming, alarming, charming and gay. First he steals your heart, then he throws it away. He will tell you of tropical nights, make you dream of a thousand delights. First he'll hold your hand, say you're simply grand, and soon you're thinking his way.
He's never been south of the border.
He's never been Argentine way.
But when he starts to pet, the chances are you'll forget that he's a caballero from Broadway. South on Broadway.
He'll hold you and say, Senorita, right here in my arms you must stay.
And from his dialect, I know you'd never suspect that he's a caballero from Broadway.
South on Broadway.
His daytime he spends parading on the avenue.
Then later, you'll always find me with a girl or two and a bird in view. He'll take you to all the gay places. He'll make every Latin cafe.
He'll give you such a thrill.
And then he'll hand you the bill, this charming caballero from Broadway.
South on Broadway.
When Madame Lazanga learned the conga, I swear, I gave her the lesson, then I gave her the air.
It seemed to be love and bloom, suddenly boom,
another girl took over from there.
I know if you meet him, you are likely to fall.
His methods are sense because it catches them all.
He'll sing you a serenade, tenderly played upon an old melodic guitar.
You bring up the subject of dancing, and all of his pupils will say, he's such an awful crumb, but no one dances a rumba like the caballero from Broadway. South on Broadway. He'll tell you he is an Argentine as big as house, but we know his hacienda is a boarding house run by Senor Krause. He's such an impetuous fellow. He's like a dog having his day. This pony Don Amigo really comes from Oswego for a caballero from Broadway. He does okay.
wonderful. Here, you better put this on before you catch cold. You know what Lotterman said? Lotterman said the band is worth $1,500 a week right now.
$1,500 a week?
Yeah.
Jimmy, that means you're a success.
I've been double-crossed. Get me a drink. Bands. Country clubs. The McCorkles. Get me a drink, do you hear?
And now I want to tell you something.
Well, it certainly took you long enough to get around to it.
No, this is just something that's been worrying me. You don't know anything about me, who I am.
Oh, as if that made any difference. You're you and I'm me.
Well, I think I'd better tell you about
this. Oh,
there
you are. Oh, you made quite an impression. Well, it'll be a different story when I tell your uncle about it. Believe me, CJ won't pay for your philandering.
Is Haskell your uncle?
Yes, now that's what I've been trying to tell you. If you'll just let me explain.
Doesn't need any explanation. It's all perfectly obvious. Sneaking into our home, pretending that you wanted to help us, and then making me think that
you're
so...
Wait a minute. Will you please let me explain?
What a cheap trick. You are a Haskell.
Hey, now, Molly, quiet. They can hear you out here.
That's fine. Hello, everybody. I have some good news for you. Every week, beginning next Thursday, Mr. Haskell, the sponsor of our program, is going to give away $1,000 in cash to somebody.
$1,000 a week? That's a lie!
Isn't that generous, folks? Now, Mr. Haskell, trick your way out of that.
I've got to get back home. How long is it going to take me to get out of here?
Well, first portage takes 2 days.
How long take you to get here?
A week.
With luck, you can make it back in a week.
A week? Huh? Let's get started.
Jimmy. Jimmy. Jimmy, my boy, congratulations. That was a marvelous idea. How did you come to think of it?
Just came out of a clear sky.
The Haskell Happiness Hour created nationwide interest in its program last night by announcing that $1,000 a week would be given away in cash.
I know. I read all the papers.
Here's Mr. Haskell.
Morning. This is your uncle's attorney, Mr. Chalmers.
Good morning.
How do you do, sir?
I won't take much of your time. Just sign this paper, please.
What is it?
A statement that you did not authorize Miss McCorkle to make that announcement last night. That she did it out of spite with intent to damage your uncle. Now sign here, please.
Now, wait a minute.
There's nothing to worry about. I'll guarantee we can get judgment against the McCorkles. They won't be able to pay, so we take their property.
And that's what your uncle's been trying to do for years.
Now, sign here, please.
That's a funny thing. I don't like to get pushed around. I also don't sign anything until I read it first. Now, how'd you like to get out of here? Both of you.
Don't you hit me again. I have my gloves.
Mr. Haskell, your uncle...
Good day, sir. Good day. Beautiful park.
Thank you, sir.
Why don't you answer the phone? Hello?
Oh, Jimmy, me boy, how are you? Oh, you want to talk to Molly? Well, I don't think it's a very good time to...
Just a moment.
You go and fight your own battles. I'm not doing it for you. Well?
Look, I hate to annoy you, but this is important. Now, that $1,000 offer you made last night, it was my idea, do you understand? Now, just don't argue. If anybody asks you anything about it, just follow Grady's advice.
Don't you tell me to keep my mouth shut. Why should I?
Well, if you don't, they'll take your home away from you.
What is this, another one of your tricks? I don't need any help from you. What?
I said, don't be stupid. I'm not doing it for you. This is for Mom and the boys.
Excuse me, sir. Mr. Louderman and Mr. Sampson are calling.
Oh, have them come in.
Yes. Come in, please.
Hello.
Hello, Jimmy. Congratulations. Your program was a knockout. Telegrams, phone calls from all over the country. People... Oh, I beg your pardon. This is Mr. Sampson.
How do you do, Mr. Sampson?
Yes, sir.
Would you sit down?
Yes, thank you. Mr. Sampson is an investigator for the federal government.
Oh, I see. Well, what's the government got to do with it?
We're only concerned with one detail, the method by which you will give away the money.
Oh, I see. Well, that oughtn't to be very hard. I never heard of anybody having any trouble giving away $1,000. Ah, let's see.
Well, you understand that it cannot be a lottery. The government wouldn't permit raffles or drawings of any description.
Oh, yes, I understand that. No, that would be... Well, how about a quiz contest?
No, I'm afraid not. It was announced that the money would be given away over the air, not to a studio audience.
Oh. Well, that sort of complicates it, doesn't it?
say, well, Oh, how about taking a city directory and sticking a pin in it, and then give the $1,000 to the fellow that gets stuck?
No. The city directory is local. This has become a national affair.
Oh, well, let's call the whole thing off and not give away my uncle's money at all.
No. The money was promised and must be given away.
Yes, if it isn't, why, my company loses its franchise. And your uncle's business is ruined.
And you will be liable to a fine and imprisonment.
Well, that's great. Well, I have quite a choice, don't I? Either I give the money away and go to jail, or I don't give the money away and go to jail.
Hand me the salt. Still mooning about Jimmy, huh? Well, believe me, you've seen the last of him. And he's probably glad he found out just what kind of a girl you really are.
All right, Mom, all right.
But it's not all right. A fine lad like Jimmy deserves a girl who really loves him. Whether he's named the Hamilton, Haskell, or Hassenpfeffer.
Well, I hope you're satisfied.
What's the matter now?
Well, nobody can figure out how to give away that $1,000. It looks like Jimmy's going to jail on account of it.
Oh, this is awful.
But Jimmy isn't responsible. He didn't make the offer. I did.
Well, he says it's his program and he's going to take the rap for it.
Then are you going to stand by and see that boy go to jail?
But Jimmy told me...
I know what he told you and why. To keep a roof over our heads. Well, I'd rather we'd lose our house than lose our pride.
Oh, Mom. I've been feeling the same way all week.
Yes. No. Not yet.
Well, gentlemen, someone's got to think of something somehow, and soon. It's tonight, you know, the program goes on the air, not next month. And we're no closer to the answer than we were a week ago.
Yes.
I got it! I got it this time, boy! It came to me just like that.
What is it?
Now, look, we'll get that bowl, you know, that great big glass bowl they used for the draft numbers?
Great, that's it,
yeah.
My boy, I'm proud of you. That'll do it.
No, gentlemen, no.
What's the matter?
It would be a lottery, and the government forbids lotteries.
No, not yet.
Okay, I'll go back and see if I can't dream up something else.
You're not sleeping up there, are you?
Sleeping? I haven't slept for days. I'm eating aspirin tablets like peanuts.
Gentlemen, I've got it.
What?
The first time I've ever been able to beat this game.
Yes?
Look,
no.
Why don't you all go down to the broadcasting station? Maybe if I was alone, I could think of something.
Okay, Jimmy, we'll get out. Sampson, come on.
Yes? No, not
Listen,
yet.
Would you put that thing off the hook and leave it off?
Thank you, sir.
Are you all right, Jimmy?
Oh, yes, yeah. I'm just beginning to get my second wind.
Well, you better think of something.
Yeah. 7:30. Hurting Jimmy yet?
No, nobody answers the phone.
How are we to go in the air?
Brother, when the chimes indicate 8 o'clock, you're on the air.
From coast to coast.
Oh. Coming, Mr. Haskell. Coming.
Well, it's about time. Why didn't you answer the telephone?
Well, madam, you see,
Well, how do you like that?
Oh!
Come on, wake up. Come on, get up. Get up, will you?
Can't do it. It's against the law.
Hello? It's Molly. Oh, get up.
You.
Yes, it's me. Now, come on.
I suppose you want to know how I'm going to give away that $1,000. Well, I haven't the slightest idea, and I'll go home. Go home.
Go home, he says. You come down out of there as fast as you can. On your feet, big boy. If you think the McCorkles are going to let any Haskell fight their battles for them, you're cuckoo.
If you think the Haskells are going to let the McCorkles kick them around, you're cuckoo, too. Now, go on. Go away.
Still going to sleep, huh?
Uh-oh. Now, just a second. Don't you dare.
Madam, you can't do that.
Where's the telephone?
What do you think you're doing?
I'm going to tell the government man exactly what happened.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes, I am.
Here, give me that.
I've made up my mind.
Let me have that.
I'm not going to that phone. No, I won't. All right. There are millions of other telephones.
That's it.
That's what?
Hands spinning around. Millions of telephones. Millions of telephone books. Parks!
And it's not a lottery.
You are.
Get my coat. Goodbye.
Happiness Hour presents the radio sensation of the nation, the Pot of Gold, featuring Horace Hite and his musical night.
And don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, before this program is over, we will give away $1,000 in cash. The method of giving it will be announced later.
Here we come, the frightened day. It's the charge of the Hite.
Did you stop the program?
I couldn't. It's on the air now.
I'll stop it if I have to tear down the studio.
Why did I ever go in the radio business to begin with?
Jimmy, where have you been? Have you got an idea?
Yeah, this is it. Take them.
What are they?
Telephone books from all over the country. Give them to me. Oh, yes.
Are you going to get the rest of them?
Yes.
Gangway.
Listen, we're going to give the money away by telephone, you understand?
You've got the books in the section of 500 pages each.
Yeah. Numbers on each one of them.
Okay.
Get the handy, boys. Oh,
listen, get a tape. Got a tape around here.
After you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Ah, that's nice going. Come on, Parks. We have to go.
Same to you. Fine work.
Ladies and gentlemen of the listening audience, here's the news you've been waiting for. $1,000 we promised you will be given away by telephone, so stand by.
Hey, that's my money you're giving away, and I won't stand for it. I'll cancel my contract at Louderman. I'll telephone you. Get me to a telephone.
All right, there's a wheel. Now, how are we going to borrow it?
Come on, boys, take home the bacon. No blame.
You two go around the back. When I yell Snooky, you borrow it.
Snooky, what's with the Snooky?
Get going.
Don't buy this beer requires 10 cents a can. Who wouldn't give a dime for a delicious and
delectable... Snooky! Oh, where have you been, my sugar plum? Why did you leave me in battle?
Madam.
Why did you been the way you did?
Madam.
Oh, Snooky.
Madam, my...
Why, you're not my Snooky at all.
A character. Do you like that?
Where are we going...
I've been robbed!
Please!
Get a policeman. Later.
Please! I've been robbed!
Gangway!
Hello, my little man. May I use your telephone?
Hey, Ma! Daniel Boone wants to borrow our telephone!
Go away, you tramp! No one uses this phone till they give away that $1,000.
Tramp! Daniel Boone!
Look out! Look out!
Hey, fella, come out of here.
All right.
Put it all right over there. Right over there.
All right, we're on the air.
Yeah, I know.
Say, you can't go in there. This ain't no hillbilly program.
That's your
mind. Stop this.
I know hillbilly.
DJ
has.
When did you get in town?
Louderman.
I want to talk to you.
Come on. All right, horse, go on.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the wheel is all ready. All ready for the first spin. The spin to determine the volume number. Larry Cotton, take it away.
And there she goes, ladies and gentlemen. This time after that first big volume number. Yes, sir, and we want that volume to have your name in it, ladies and gentlemen.
And furthermore, I'm not going to give away one penny.
Okay. Well, I've got three men in the sponsors room right now who are begging to buy this program.
Buy it? They must be crazy.
Oh, is that so? Well, they represent the biggest advertising agencies in this country.
What? Wait a minute! Wait a minute!
We want you to be the one that Horace is going to call a little bit later. She's going down to get this volume number. Coming back just a little bit further and on and on and on. And it's 124.
124.
124.
124. 124. Here, I've got it.
Now we're all ready for the second spin. The spin to determine the page number. Larry, let her go.
And there we go, ladies and gentlemen, on that second big spin, the one to find the page in that volume we told just a moment ago, the one page that will have that $1,000 pot of golden name on it.
Gentlemen, this is Mr. Haskell.
How do you do, gentlemen?
The surest fire advertising stunt I've ever seen.
You want to sell it?
Is it good?
I'll give you $20,000 for it right now.
Is it that good? I might get 30.
Trying to steal it, huh?
And she's slowing down already just to find this right page, and there she's stopping, and it's page 66.
Page 66.
66!
I got it!
And now the third and last spin to determine the name of the person on that page who will receive the actual golden telephone call. Larry, take it away.
There we go, ladies and gentlemen. This time through all of the names on our chosen page in our chosen volume. Find just the one right name that we can send this $1,000 pot of gold to. She's down at the bottom and coming back a little bit, slowing down more and more and more and more. And there it is. Our listing is 38.
Listing number 38.
Ten, 20. 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, it's...
What? Oh, it's the name is Mr. Olaf Swenson, 3RJ, Ring 7. Ring 7?
Plunkett, Minnesota.
Operator, kindly give me Mr. Olaf Swenson, 3RJ, Ring 7, Plunkett, Minnesota.
That's right.
Hello.
Stop the clock, boy. Stop the clock.
Hello.
Hello. Is this Mr. Olaf Swenson speaking?
Yeah. Yeah, that's me, Olaf. A pot of what? A towel? You give me... Say, I ain't got no time for monkey business. What? You give me $1,000? Hold up!
Look, why you make my only faint? What?
Hello? 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 Folks, they're speechless.
It's a $1 million idea, and it's all mine, all mine.
Oh, so they brought you back alive, did they?
What are you doing here?
I'm enjoying our program.
Your program? What are you trying to put over on me now? It belongs to me, you understand?
It does it? Why, the whole thing was Molly's idea.
Molly's idea? Who is Molly?
I want to tell you.
It's all right. We got you out of the whole mess.
You're not liable for anything connected with the program. We fixed it so Miss McCorkle is responsible for the whole thing.
Molly!
You nitwits! You nutcase!
Get out of here!
Get out of here!
Get out of here!
Oh, and Molly is responsible for the whole thing.
Yeah.
Hey, where are you going?
Out.
Oh. Horace got the call through on the telephone, so it guess everything's fine.
Yes, everything's fine.
Yeah. Well, I guess it's just one of those things. The McCorkles are allergic to the Haskells.
Vice versa.
Yeah, vice versa.
Bob,
Where are Jimmy?
Uncle Charlie.
Well, oh, you come with me.
Come on, you're in on this too.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce the two young people who originated this program and which will be a permanent feature of the Haskell Happiness Hour. Miss Molly McCorkle and my nephew, Mr. James Haskell. Say something. Tell them how happy you are.
Hello, everybody. I just want to tell you how happy I am that everything turned out so well for everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, the reason she's so happy is that we're going to be married any second now. All right, Miss McCorkle, trick your way out of that one.
Hey, John!